Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we're going to look at how you can easily import just about any type of data into Excel using Power Query and Copilot. Whether it's web data, internal content, or even data from other spreadsheets, you can bring it all in with just a simple prompt. And the best part, your data stays in sync automatically. Let's dive in. Here I am in Microsoft Excel. And first, we're going to see if we could pull in web content using Copilot. You can search the web directly within Copilot to find public information like dates, statistics, and more. On this sheet, I have various cookies that we offer here at the Kevin Cookie Company, along with the price in USD or United States dollars. I would also like to list the price in all these different currencies, but I don't know what the exchange rate is. So let's see if Copilot can help with this. To access Copilot, up on the top tabs, click on Home, and then all the way over on the right-hand side, we have an icon for Copilot. We could click on this. Or alternatively, you can click directly into one of the cells on your worksheet, and here too, you'll also see a Copilot icon. And when you click on this, down at the bottom of this menu, we have the option to ask Copilot. Let's try this. This opens up a pane over on the right-hand side, and at the very top, we see a few different suggested prompts, just to give us some inspiration for what's possible with Copilot. But I have something very specific in mind. I want to know these exchange rates. So down at the bottom, we have a text field where I can type in my own prompt, and I'll type in make a table showing the current exchange rates between all of these different currencies. This data is available on the web. Let's see if Copilot can fetch this. Let's send it. Right up above, it looks like Copilot has returned all of the different exchange rates. Right down below, I can also see the source for these different exchange rates. Right over here, I have the option now to insert to a new sheet. Let's click on this. This now drops me on a new sheet where I have a table with all of the different currencies and the current exchange rate, fresh from the web. Now, of course, I didn't just generate the exchange rates just to have exchange rates. I need to do something with them. Let's jump back into the exchange rates sheet. And here again, I have all my different prices in USD, and I want to know the price that I should charge in all of these different local currencies. Once again, let's see if Copilot can help. In the bottom right-hand corner, I still have that pane open, and I'll type in a new prompt. Calculate the prices for these cookies in local currencies based on their USD prices. Let's see if it'll use that exchange rate table that I inserted on the other sheet. Copilot came back with a solution. And here, if I review the function that it uses, it looks like it's referencing that exchange rate table on the other sheet. And down below, I can preview the data. And I double-checked a few of the values, and it looks like it's doing it accurately. Right over here, I can now insert all of these columns. Over on the left-hand side, it's added new columns with all of the prices for these different local currencies. Unfortunately, it did not use my existing columns, but I kind of get it. Copilot only adds new data. It never overwrites existing content that you have in your spreadsheet. Chances are, that'll probably save me in the long run. Let's try fetching some more data from the web. I've always been curious about whether the Kevin Cookie Company is one of the largest companies in the world. I'll type in my prompt. Can you give me a list of the 10 largest companies in the world sorted by market cap in a table format? Let's send that. Right up above, we can see the output. And right down here, we could insert this onto a new sheet. Let's do that. This has now inserted the data onto a new sheet. Oh, wait a minute. The Kevin Cookie Company is not even on the list? What? This has to be a bug. Next, we're going to look at how you can import internal content into Excel. Like, let's say content from Word, PowerPoint, or even your email and calendar. I feel like I spend a lot of time in meetings, but I've never analyzed the data to understand the problem. I'd like to know how I spend my time. Let's see if Copilot can help with this ad hoc research. Here on a new sheet, over on the bottom right-hand corner, I have my Copilot pane. I'll type in a prompt. Show me this week's meetings in a table. Let's send that. Right up above, it's pulled in all of my meetings from my Outlook calendar. Let's insert this onto a new sheet. Look at this ridiculous meeting load. This is far too much. Who's the organizer for all these different meetings? Oh, it looks like I am the cause of this calendar chaos. One neat thing is you can continue prompting the AI to get all the details from your calendar that you would like to see. Here, for example, I don't see any of the meeting descriptions, but let's try asking Copilot if it can also provide that information. In the bottom right, I'll type in my prompt. Can you also include the description? Let's send that. Right up above, let's now insert this new result into a new sheet. This has now inserted a new table including all of the different meeting descriptions. Again, you could pull in any type of content directly into Excel, as long as you have that content stored within Microsoft 365. Next, we're going to look at how you can pull organizational data into Excel. Now, most of you probably think that I own and run the Kevin Cookie Company. It is, after all, named after me, but we have a CEO and a president. Let me show you the org structure. Over on the right-hand side, again, in the Copilot pane, all the way down at the bottom, in that text field, I'll type in a prompt that says, show me a table with all employees who report to Patty Fernandez. She's our CEO. Let's send that. Up above, it pulls in data from Azure Active Directory, showing me all the different people who report to Patty. And here too, I could click on Insert to New Sheet, and here I see all of her direct reports. All of this is well and good, but can you import data from another Excel sheet and keep it updated? And yes, you absolutely can. Traditionally, you would need to know something called Power Query. If you click on data up on top, over here, you could import data from different places, and it would take care of importing and syncing the data from another Excel file. This is a really powerful tool that lets you automate updates and format your data before importing. If you're curious, I have a full Power Query tutorial linked in the description. But with Copilot, you can now just describe what you want, and it handles the rest. I have another spreadsheet in SharePoint that contains all of our customer orders here at the Kevin Cookie Company. I want to do some analysis in this sheet, but I want it to be in sync with that other spreadsheet. So down in the right-hand corner in this text field, I'll type in a prompt. Show me all customer orders in a table. The customer orders are stored in another spreadsheet in SharePoint. Let's see if it could find that spreadsheet and then bring it into Excel. Look at that. It finds the other spreadsheet and it can also extract the data from a table in that spreadsheet. And I can see it and preview it all right here. Now, right over here, I could also click into the source. That way I can confirm that this is in fact the right spreadsheet. And there I see it's called customer orders. That's the right spreadsheet. Right over here, I can click on show tables to import. Let's try this. Right down below, let's click on import to new sheet. It's now inserted the table from that other Excel sheet. But here's the beautiful thing. This is now connected to that other Excel sheet. So if anything gets updated on the original source sheet, that update will flow through to this table. Let's jump over to the other sheet and make an update there. Here I am on the original sheet, and I see Peter White has a pending order. Let's change the delivery status to delivered. I'll take this status, paste it there, and let's now see if that flows through. Excel has now made a connection between these two different sheets. Right up on top, I can click on this tab for query. And right here, we see the option to refresh. So when I refresh this sheet, it'll reflect all of the changes on the other spreadsheet. Let's click on refresh. And right down here, Peter White, it says delivered. This feels like spreadsheet magic. So now you know, Excel can search the web, dig through your files, and pull data from other spreadsheets. And still, somehow it doesn't recognize that the Kevin Cookie Company is a Fortune 10 business. Tragic. Maybe someday it'll be ready for prime time. If this video helped you, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one.